Just another quick note to help you out. This video demonstrates overriding a template copied from the core theme Classy. This is no longer considered best practice. Instead, what you will want to do is copy the file with the same name from the Stable 9 theme. So to repeat, use Stable 9 templates instead of Classy. Hope this helps. Let's go. Now that you understand how template overrides are done, let's go ahead and try it out for ourselves. Have your Drupal site up and running and the project code loaded in your code editor. When you are ready, let's begin. The very first thing we need to do is actually change the main navigation menu block to be rendered by our theme. So to do this, head over to Structure and then Block Layout and find the main navigation block and drag it down to the content. And it should be the first block in the content region, right above page title. So when you've done that, go ahead and click Save Blocks. And now when we return home, we'll see that the main navigation links are now appearing. Let's set up our Drupal site with the content we need for this activity. Previously, we had created a quotes basic page. Let's create a menu link for it. So I'll visit Content, and then click on Edit for this basic page content. I'm going to add a menu link titled Quotes to the main navigation. Remember to click Save to make it official. Next, let's create a piece of content different from the one we just modified. Since the Quotes page is a basic page, let's now begin to create an article. So proceed to create an article however you wish. I'll hover over Content, Add Content, and select Article. Feel free to populate the content however you wish here. If you want, follow along and let's have some fun with positive affirmation. I'll title the article as Beach Wisdom. For the body, I'll simply type, I radiate beauty, charm, and grace. Let's also create a menu link for this article in the main navigation menu. Excellent. When you are ready, be sure to click Save. Fantastic. Now let's begin to override a core template with our simple smart theme. I'll begin within my code editor. First, create a directory within the simple smart theme directory at web themes custom simple smart. Within simple smart, create a new directory called templates. Super. In this exercise, we are going to override the node template. Since our simple smart theme is based upon Classy, we need to copy the node template from the Classy theme. So follow along and copy the node template how you can, either with the file browser, command line, or within your code editor. I'm going to be using the file browser. The default node.twig.html template for Classy can be found at core themes classy templates content, and here it is, node.html.twig. When you have located the correct file, copy it into our simple smart templates directory. Nice work. Now, Be sure to open this newly copied node.html.twig template, and let's make a visible change by adding a noticeable text below the title suffix. This will likely be somewhere around line 92. Look for the variable called title suffix. When you have located title suffix, enter something below it, something simple, such as a header one, I am a node. Great. After you have added the new line to the node template, be sure to save the file. Then head back over to your site. Remember to always flush the cache after you make changes to your theme. So flush cache now. The change we are expecting to see is that our newly added I am a node header will be displayed on any content type. Verify that now by visiting both contents we created earlier. Since I am already at the Beach Wisdom article, I can see the I am a node header here. The next step is to then verify that this header also appears on other nodes, such as the basic page we created earlier. I'll visit the content now by clicking on the link here in the menu. Brilliant. Whether we view an article or a basic page, we see that we are overriding the node template, which affects any node content. So this completes the first phase of this activity. Congratulations. Next, let's learn how to override a node template by content type. Overriding by content type is done by setting the name of the template file. So when you're ready, return to your code editor. Have the node.html.twig file open and save it as node-article.html.twig. This is the way to let Drupal know that this template is to only affect nodes of type article. After you have created the node-article template file, let's make a visible change to it and a specific change to the node article template. This time, change the H1 text from I am a node change to I am an article. Be sure to save the template file. Now, let's view our work on our site. So head back over to your site. What we are expecting to see is the basic page still showing the I am a node heading. Since I am here on the basic page already, I need to clear the cache to have Drupal reflect the template update. Clear cache. Excellent. And remember, the article should now show the I am an article heading. Go ahead and verify that now. Yes, we can see that at this time, both node template overrides are active. However, for demonstration purposes, we don't need the broad node template override. So go ahead and delete the node.html.twig template file from our Simple Smart theme when you are able. Again, to view our changes of deleted node.html twig file, head back over to the site and flush the cache. Verify that the I am an article heading still appears on the article. And the basic page should no longer show the heading. Awesome! Congratulations on understanding how template overrides work. Remember, to always make a copy of the core template and place the copy into your own themes templates directory. Well done. See you in the next videos. Happy learning.